It's the Frank Show. What? The Frank Show. Come on, the Frank Show. What? The Frank Show. Come on, the Frank Show. What? The Frank Show. Come on, the Frank Show. Bitch, it's time for the show. Aloha, headsets, it's your boy Frank, and it is time for the Frank Show. Now, have you experienced tracking issues, wobbling, any problems with your PlayStation VR and your PlayStation VR camera? What if I told you I had a way to fix all those problems? Well, not all of them, but a pretty solid solution for most of them. Would you be interested? Hey, you're in the right place, because that's what this video is about. Now, sit back, relax, and enjoy a little discussion and how to make your PlayStation VR tracking nearly perfect. Alright, I must start this all off by letting you know this is not my findings. I wish it had been, and it was found by someone far more intelligent than I, but that is besides the point. He wanted me to share this with the community, and that's exactly what I'm doing, because everybody deserves the greatest experience possible. Now, unlike other major HMDs, the PlayStation VR uses a camera for tracking, which, don't get me wrong, it works wonderfully, but it has its downfalls, and that's what we're gonna try to solve today. Now, when you set up your camera, it's you setting it up. You're a human, and as always, humans are prone to error, so you were probably not even paying attention at original time that you were matching up the lights and this and that, and you really need that to be perfect, because I mean, that's what it is. That's how the computer is reading those sensors. And today we're gonna go over how to do that as beautifully as possible. Now, a little understanding of what's going on first. Now, your PlayStation 4 is blind as a bat. And when you plug an eye in, you are letting it see. But just because it can see, it has absolutely no idea what it's looking at. It has no idea what's up. It has no idea what's down, left, right, or any of that. That is where you come in. With your PlayStation VR and the lights on the front, you are able to show this camera something in the real world that it is able to use and track and understand placement, space, everything in the real world. So don't you think that's important to get set up, right? Well, it is, of course. So setting that all up and making that correct is what is gonna help your PlayStation 4 see the world much better and understand its depth to a greater degree. Now, to start this all off, you're gonna wanna have a table and you're gonna wanna have some sort of stand. A mannequin head is definitely the best for your PlayStation VR. Now, you're gonna wanna take the table and put your camera at one end and your PlayStation VR on its stand at the other end, and you want both of them to be perpendicular for the moment. You want them to be straight on the x-axis. So your camera needs to be as straight as can be, matching up as straight as can be with your PlayStation VR on the other end, as you can see in the video. Now, once you've got this perfectly, you need to look at your camera on the screen and make sure that your lights are tracked up. You may have to move your headset up or down a little bit, but you need the perfect spot. Now, as you see, I have a post-it note on the front of my headset. That way I can match up my top two lights without it just jumping to the next screen. Now, what I want to do is pull that post-it note off, and when it jumps to the next screen, I want it to immediately go to the next screen, then track my bottom lights, and then go to the next screen over that. I don't want to have to move my headset at all when I go from that first sensor reading to the second sensor reading. This is a key part. If you cannot get it with this first sensor reading and the second sensor reading perfect, you need to start all over. You need to adjust your camera a little, adjust your headset, move it up, get it so these two are parallel. Now, once you've gotten through that and through the other second sensor reading, you have to read it on the side. Now, on the side is a bit tricky. If you look behind my headset, I got a little piece of post-it note with a marker on the ground so I can make sure to go back to the original spot if I need to. Now, to read the side sensor, you need to turn your HMD, not your stand, not the back of it, the actual HMD 90 degrees in space. And you try to get it as perfect 90 degrees as you can. And if you can get it that perfect 90 degrees, and once the sensors start tracking, you should not have to move your headset whatsoever. That baby should move to 90 degrees, bam, the lights start tracking up. If they don't work, you gotta start back with the original step one. I told you, it's a bit of a difficult process. It takes a little time, but I promise you, it is gonna help you so much at the end. Now, you got that done. You got the side done. Next up is the back. Now, there's no perfect science to the back. This one's a bit more difficult. I rotated my device again 90 degrees and just kind of tried to match it up. You're trying to get to where the headset band is basically straight on with the camera, but it's not perfect and it's not easy. And it's better if you don't take it off your stand so you don't mess up the up and down or where you put your headset. So try to leave it on there, tilt it a little bit, get it right, and you should be able to get that one. Next up, you want to go back to your original placement because you got to do the other side. You want to rotate it that 90 degrees again, and it should match up perfectly with the other side. As long as it is doing that, you are solid. You go through the whole process and you're good to go. That is how you calibrate your PlayStation VR to near perfection. Now, you're always gonna have issues, but at least when you do this, now you can move your camera wherever you want in the house, and the camera knows how to read the PlayStation VR perfectly. It knows where the lights are placed. It knows exactly how it should look at its optimal supreme setting so that whenever you're in any other situation, it gets what's going on. And I hope that this helps you, and I hope that you can get everything going from this, because that's what we're here for on the channel. All right, and that's it. Now, honestly, like I said, you guys, it took me a little while to get this perfect, but once I got it perfect, it honestly has made my experience a lot better. So please, try it at home. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them, and hopefully Frank can help you out. And as always, thank you all for coming through. You're the most amazing audience in the world. Give yourselves a thumbs up, a round of applause, and hey, if you think I deserve one, then throw me one as well. But more important than all of that is that if you want to stay up to date on everything PlayStation VR, and you don't mind this ugly mug, friggin' subscribe. I mean, come on. Smooches. And that's how you do it right there, collaboration.